Good morning. Whatever the time might be where you are joining us, welcome to Sunday worship with St. Andrew's Church. Today being the sixth day of December and the second Sunday in the season of Advent, we gather to worship the Lord. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Let us worship God. From seed to shoot, God's kingdom is coming. God's kingdom is coming near. Rooted and growing, God's kingdom is coming. God's kingdom is coming near. Flourishing and blossoming, God's kingdom is coming. God's kingdom is coming near. Let us now turn our hearts to God in prayer. Let us pray. Almighty God, we stand in awe of you for the dignity of your person. You are holy, just, and true. We acknowledge that with respect to all humanity, you are Creator, Lawgiver, and Judge. Knowing this makes us rejoice with all the more that in relation to your chosen people, you are our Savior, our Redeemer, and Friend. You are constant in love and faithfulness, generous, compassionate, merciful, and forgiving. Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you through our faults in thought, in word, in deed, and in what we have left undone. For the sake of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, forgive us all our offenses, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life to the glory of your name. And as we gather to worship you, may we experience the joy and peace of your presence. Increase our faith in the sure and certain knowledge of your justice satisfied, your anger turned aside, our sins forgiven, our life redeemed, our soul saved, and eternity made ours through Christ our Lord. Let us now say the prayer our Lord taught us. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debt as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Come.
Let me now invite one of our children from the Club Sunday to light the second Advent candle, Daniel.
Candle burns, the sign of your word. God of the prophets, come to us again this Advent. May your word be a lamp to our feet and a light on our path.
Amen.
He came so far, understand. listening to the word of God. Today's reading is taken from Isaiah chapter 40, reading from verse 1. Comfort, comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and proclaim to her that her hard service has been completed, that her sin has been paid for, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A voice of one calling in the desert, prepare the way for the Lord, make straight in the wilderness a highway for our God. Every valley shall be raised up, every mountain and hill made low. The rough ground shall become level, the rugged places a plain. And the glory of the Lord will be revealed, and all mankind together will see it. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken. A voice says, cry out. And I said, what shall I cry? All men are like grass, and all their glory is like the flowers of the field. The grass withers and the flowers fall, because the breath of the Lord blows on them. Surely the people are grass. The grass withers and the flowers fall, but the word of our God stands forever. You who bring good tidings to Zion, go up on a high mountain. You who bring good tidings to Jerusalem, lift up your voice with a shout. Lift it up, do not be afraid. Says to the towns of Judah, here is your God. See, the sovereign Lord comes with power, and his arm rules for him. See, his reward is with him, and his recompense accompanies him. He tends his flock like a shepherd. He gathers the lambs in his arms and carries them close to his heart. He gently leads those that have young. May God bless to us the reading of his holy word. Amen.
Let us prepare our hearts to hear the word of God. Comfort, comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and proclaim to her that her hard service has been completed, that her sins has been paid for. Let us pray. Gracious God, give us humble, teachable, and obedient hearts, that we may receive what you have revealed and do what you have commanded. Amen. I will begin the message with a very short story. On February 27th, 1991, during the Desert Storm War, a woman by name of Ruth Dillo received the worst call of her life. Her son, Clinton Carpenter, private first class, had stepped on a landmine and was dead. For the next 3 days, she grieved. No one could comfort her. On the third day, after receiving the terrible news, the phone rang again. On the other end of the phone, there was a voice that said to her, Mom, it's I. I'm alive. At first, she thought it was a cruel joke, but as the conversation continued, she realized it was indeed her son. Later, she said, She laughed and cried and rejoiced, because what seemed to be a hopeless situation turned out to be the greatest day of her life. That is what news from a graveyard can do for you when your faith is in Jesus Christ. The greatest comfort. The greatest comfort. The theme of comfort sounds good, isn't it? But think about when you just can't fairly get comfortable. Bones ache, thoughts ruminate, you are restricted to do things you want to do. Thoughts of pandemic devastated, so on and so forth. Even when we find comfort, it seems temporary, elusive. It is here one moment and gone the next moment. Yet, today's passage speaks of God's lasting eternal comfort to his people. The first 11 verses of Isaiah chapter 40 express God's comfort packaged in three ways. And to this we turn our attention. Firstly, from verses 1 and 2, we can take comfort that our sins are forgiven. After 39 chapters of judgment, Isaiah begins chapter 40 with God saying, comfort. In fact, God said it twice. Comfort, comfort my people. Now, notice the personal pronoun he used. God says, these are my people. He claims them as his own. They have wandered. The exile was a direct consequence of their sin. Yet, God says, their sins are paid for in full. Old Testament saints, we are saved by looking forward to a Messiah. We who live on this side of the cross look back to the source of our salvation. We know our Savior. We know our Messiah. And his name is Jesus Christ. He is our salvation. We bring our sins to God through him. We need to understand one thing as we progress, that one sin blocks any kind of relationship we have with him. Yet, when Jesus died on the cross, God took our debts and declared us ransomed. As we bring all our guilt and shame to Christ, God forgives us. And this is what Christmas tells us. It tells us that in Christmas, everything is new. This Christmas, at least, take comfort that your sins has been paid for in full. Secondly, we take comfort that God's word outlasts our problems. Verses 6 to 8 are strange group of verses tucked into the middle of our scripture reading today. And it speaks to the frailty of human life. As big as your problem may seem, as big as this challenge might seem, as dry as your wilderness may be, and as lonely as your exile may appear, as difficult as the restriction for pandemic may be, God's word is bigger than it all. Your circumstances are temporary. Our circumstances are temporary. God's word is forever. It is eternal. You don't have the final word on your circumstances until we have God's word on the matter. For God's word is the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the A and the Amen in everything. This Christmas, again, take comfort that God's word endures over your problems, and it endures forever. And finally, we take comfort that God is coming again to us. Isaiah writes that something exciting is about to happen. We can tell because of the major construction going on in verse 3 to 5. And it says, a voice of one calling in the wilderness, prepare the way for the Lord, make straight the desert, a highway for our God. Every valley shall be filled, raised up, every mountain and hill made low. The rough ground shall become level, the rugged places made plain, and the glory of the Lord will be revealed, and all people will see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. And so, after some 700 years that Isaiah first wrote these words, then came John the Baptist, and he declared these words as he prepared the way for the long-awaited Messiah. And we are told in verses 9 to 11 that a king is coming to us. And he describes the king. He is both mighty and meek. He is powerful as a conquering warrior, but also as gentle as a shepherd with a lamb. Think about it. This is a God worth following. The one true God is both strong and caring. This God moves nations, and he holds little lambs close to his heart. He knows your name. He knows where you are, and he knows your circumstances. He is great, great God, but also a good God. The greatest comfort we have is that he is coming again to us. Now we prepare for his second advent. All you need to do is to straighten out the crooked places of your life. Get yourself ready. Stand firm in faith, for your king is coming to you. Wait on him, for they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. Amen. Let us pray. Now to him who is able to keep you from falling and to present you before his presence without fault and with great joy, to the only God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, power and authority through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by. Yet in thy dark street shineth the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight. For Christ is born of Mary and gathered all above. While mortals sleep, the angels keep their watch of wandering love. Oh, morning stars together proclaim the holy birth, and praises sing to God the King, and peace to men on earth. How silently the wondrous gift is given. So God imparts to human hearts the blessings of His hem. No ear may hear His coming, but in this world of sin, where meek souls will receive Him still, the dear Christ enters in. Oh, holy child of Bethlehem, descend to us, we pray. Cast out our sin and enter in, be born in us today. We hear the Christmas angels, the great glad tidings tell. Oh, come to us, abide with us, our Lord Emmanuel.
Let us bring our prayers of thanksgiving and intercession for others before God. Let us pray. Sovereign Lord, we give thanks to you for everything you have made. Summer and winter, sunshine and rain, seed time and harvest. You have made day and night, heat and cold, for work and rest. We are grateful, Lord, as each of these circles of life serves our welfare and speaks to us of your tender care and your fatherly goodness, but also of your mercy. Your mercy and grace are seen in family who love us, in friends who support us, in laws that defend us, in homes that shelter us, in food that nourishes us. But all of these your blessings, Lord, cannot begin to compare with the vast extent of your wisdom and grace that planned and accomplished our redemption through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Savior. Merciful God, you sent your messengers, the prophets, to preach repentance and prepare the way for our salvation. Give us grace to heed their warnings and forsake our sins, that we may greet with joy the coming of Christ Jesus, our Redeemer, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever. Eternal God, you are the God of those who think themselves godless. You are the rock on which our lives are built. Have mercy on those who try to live without you, and lead them gently to the truth that sets us free. Come afresh to the minds of those who think they have thought their way out of your reach. Come afresh to those of us who think we have it all tapped, for of whom your mystery and power have become dull and routine. Come afresh to the hearts of us all, whether they be full of distractions or sweat clean and empty. We long for you to be central to our lives and central to the life of the world. God of goodness and grace, shine as a lamp to all who are in darkness. Provide food that sustains to all who are hungry. Bring hope of release to those who are suffering. Bring restoration and healing to our broken world. Meet each person in our community, our nation, our world at large, at the very point of their need, and wipe every tear from every eye. With Christmas, bring joy and peace to every home, we pray. Your kingdom come, your will be done. Holy God, this Advent, we set ourselves to longing again, longing and waiting and hoping. We long for your kingdom to come and for this world to be transformed, for it to be on earth as it is in heaven. Come, Advent God, with the promise of a new birth in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.
Heaven.
Thank you for joining in today's service. As we continue to wait for the second advent of our Lord and Savior, go in peace and serve the Lord. May the God of hope fill you with joy and peace in believing, so that by the power of the Holy Spirit, you may abound in hope, now and forevermore. Amen.